Resolved on the first affirmative, speaking on the president's plan for immigration reform, Senate Bill S-44. The reason why it's important is we currently have about 11.7 million immigrants living in the United States illegally. This is according to the New York Times, which also searched the Pew Research Center for Hispanic Trends. Now, we want to look at why is 11.7 a problem. I understand it's not that big of a population, but I'll start listing off the cost. According to the Center for Immigration Studies, in an article called Illegal Immigration and the Federal Budget, we know that we're spending $2.5 billion a year on Medicaid. We're spending $1.9 billion a year on food assistance, such as food stamps and WIC free school lunches. Now, on a bigger scale, we're spending $22 billion a year on welfare to illegal aliens by each year by state governments. Now, the real thing we're spending money on is the amount of legal prisoners. About 21% of the population of U.S. prisons is classified as non-citizens, generally from Mexico, Colombia, Cuba, and the Dominican Republic. Okay. So the annual taxpayer costs in the U.S. state is about $31,286 per inmate. The United States has less than 5% of the world's population and 24% of the world's prison population. We incarcerate a lot of people, and 21% of those are non-immigrants that are paying for $31,286 per inmate. So 20% of the inmates that we have, that's 7.2 million people that we have in prison, 20% of that is 1.5 million about, 1.5 million times the 31,000. It's $47,300,400,000. So we're spending that annually. Now, this bill is only going to cost us $30 billion, and the majority of it is spent securing our borders against what we're clearly filling up our prison system with, because the people that are listed off are coming from a southern area. Now, how do we know we're going to be sending out these people with a bill? Because we now have inadmissibility and deportability. So when you go to court now, if you, or at any time, if you have done certain crimes, we're not going to have you here, we're going to deport you. And until you're sitting, we either find them inadmissible and you just pay your taxes, and we wouldn't deport you on certain things, we're clearly not gonna send you off because of a traffic citation when you've applied to do things legally. So we're not just letting anybody in. On top of that, we're sending out the bad. We're not just letting one in. If enacted, S-44 would require a series of enforcement measures or triggers to go into effect prior to completing the legalization process. For example, although undocumented immigrants will be allowed to register for the new Register Provisional Immigrant Program, or RPI, almost immediately before those RPI status can apply to become full lawful permanent residents of the Department of Homeland Security must certify that a comprehensive southern border security strategy is deployed and operational. So that's saying before we give out any of the citizenship, we're going to make sure that we're not going to be having any more in. So we're going to give them an opportunity to apply for a program, the RPI, the Registered Provisional Immigrant, that doesn't make them citizens immediately. RPI actually takes 6 years to get it. Not everyone's actually eligible for RPI. People that are eligible is the bill will allow undocumented immigrants to apply for registered provisional immigrant status if they have been in the U.S. since December 31st, 2011. So people, this isn't going to cause a huge increase of people running across the border that we put a time cap on it. You can't apply for it if you just run across the border right now. You have to be here since 2011. And then if you were to go to court, I already showed you that you're going to be just sent back across the border because we're not dealing with that anymore. We're not putting more people in prisons. We acknowledge 20%. Our people in there. On top of that, when you want to go do this, you have to not have been convicted of a felony or three or more misdemeanors. You have to pay their asset taxes, pass background checks, pay applications and fees, and $1,000 penalty. So the people that are coming here are having more of a background check than any of your neighbors you've ever lived with in your entire life. It's safer. So we're going to be looking at how many visas we're going to be bringing in. It's between 120 and 250,000 visas a year. that's people that can apply to become citizens within 6 years. So it's not like we're letting in a 250,000 people a year or capping it because it's hugely backlog. We're saying we have to have a minimum of 120,000 coming in just to clear things up. So it's a problem, and the system acknowledges it and finds a way to work through it. Here's how it'll unclog it. The current immigration visa system has created enormous backlogs of applicants who sometimes have to wait decades to get immigration visas. So we're scanning through these people, deciding who we want in, and giving a visa to ones quicker. We're not making them wait 10 years. This track will clear the backlog of applicants by allocating visas to applicants with pending applications over the course of 7 years starting in 2015, allowing these immigrants to qualify for lawful permanent residency by 2021. Now, it's a merit system. The merit point system allows foreign nationals to obtain lawful permanent residence in the United States by accumulating points, mainly based on their skills, employment history, and educational credentials. So we're going to be letting intelligent people in, we're going to be letting people in that work, and people that are highly skilled. At the same time, the current immigration visa categorizes for siblings, adult, married children of U.S. citizens. So on top of people that have worked and all that, if you have family, you don't necessarily have to be skilled, we're going to come let you live with your family. We still have things that allow families to get together. We're not just deporting miscellaneous people. Call that time.